Good morning, children. Today I'm going to take second exercise of in this chapter, right? Chapter 4, concurrency of triangles. That is, see, listen here, concurrency of triangles. Now we are going to learn a very important geometrical concept called concurrency. That means that same shape and same size. Okay, so before that, to understand the concept of concurrency of triangles, let us first look into the concurrency of shapes. Here I have 500 rupees notebook. See, look at these notes, all four notes, it has same shape and size, right? Suppose if I do like this, so this it will look like a one notebook. So here I kept all the notebooks in one position. So now here you can see this is like one notebook, right? So but here down we have four notebooks, right? So all these notes have same shape and size, so we can call this as concurrence figure. All these notebooks are concurrency, same shape and same size, right? Next I'll go with the ruler. That is, here I have two scales. So these two scales are same length and width, everything. So suppose if I kept one above other, see, look at this. Now we can't able to see the another scale, right? So see, like this. Yes children, is it clear? So these two scales are concurrent. Yes, so any pair or set of objects with this property are said to be concurrent. Yes children, so let us see what is line segment, that is concurrency of line segment. I'll go with concurrency of line segment. Now here we have two lines, measure and see these two lines. Just now the length of AB is, see, length of AB is 3.2 centimeter, and CD also 3.2 centimeter. So we can say these two lines are concurrent. These two lines are concurrent. That is, for example, here if I drawn a line segment, two lines A, B, C, D. Look at these two lines. These two lines are same length. So we can say these two lines are concurrent. So that is, lines are concurrent if they have the same length. So if we have two lines, the two lines are same length. Now we can say that two lines are concurrent. Let us see concurrency of angles. Concurrency of angles. Now see, look at these two diagrams. These two triangles have the same angle. So we can say these two angles are concurrents. Okay, now we can see the conditions of concurrency. See, listen here. Concurrence of triangles, we have many conditions. That is, five important conditions are there. We are going to see one by one, right? So before that, if two figures are concurrent, now we can use this symbol. That is, if these two lines are concurrent, line AB and CD, these two lines are concurrent, we can mention that as line AB is concurrent, equal, same shape and length. One curved line we have to draw like this. So symbol, meaning of this symbol is concurrent, that is same. Meaning of the symbol is concurrency. Okay, AB, line AB is concurrent to line CD. Yes children, right? Now concurrency of triangle. Concurrency of triangle. Now look at these two triangle, children. Here AB in red color, ZY also in pink red color, that is in pink in color, and CB is green and XY in green, and AC is blue and XZ is in blue in color. So these two triangles are concurrent. How we can say? Just we have to measure and see this length. Definitely AB is equal to ZY and AC is equal to XZ and BC is equal to XY. If we take and keep this triangle on this triangle, so these two figures will match us identically. Okay, so we can say these two angles are these two triangles are concurrent. Okay, so for this I'm going to show you that example. Before that, conditions for triangles to be concurrent. First condition, side concurrency criteria. Here I am going to show this criteria with one example. Listen here. Here I have two triangles. See? Right. Here I have two triangles, children. See, right. The same way I told in this picture, I showed to you, know this diagram. This is one triangle, this is another triangle. Like that, here I have, this is one triangle. This one I'll take it as another triangle, right? So now, how can we say these two triangles are SSS criterion? That is side. That means both these triangle, all the three sides are equal. So suppose if I'll take and kept this triangle over this triangle like this now. See children. So these two triangles are matching in this way, right? Yes, children, these two triangles are matching. So this side are equal, both the triangle, this side are equal, and this side also equal, and this side also equal. See, if I'll separate these two triangles, these two sides are equal, and these two sides are equal, and these two sides are equal. So we can say these two triangles are concurrent based on the condition SSS, that is side criterion. Am I clear? This is the first condition. How we can say these two triangles are concurrent? Based on this condition, side. These two triangles, if matched it like this, these two sides are equal. And the same way, these two sides are equal and these two sides are equal. So we can say these two triangles are concurrent, right? Now, I'll go with second criteria, that is SAS. See, here, SAS criteria, SAS criteria means side, angle, side. Right. So here I have two more triangles. Look at these two triangles, children. One green and one pink. Here I have two triangles. Here I am going to show these two triangles are concurrent based on the condition SAS. So here, suppose if I take and keep this triangle on this triangle like this, these two triangles are not matching. So what we have to do now, based on this, that is these two angles are equal, here I mention it, that is angles I put like this, these two angles are equal mention panirka. So we have to match it like this. See, now we can't see that green color triangle now. Yes. So only we can able to see this pink triangle. So pink and the green triangles are same size and shape. So suppose if you want to keep this one up, you can see like this. See, now also it is very clear. These two triangles are same shape and size. Based on which condition? Now this side and this side are equal and this angle is equal. Yes, so we can say these two triangles are concurrent based on which condition? SAS criterion, that is side angle side criterion. Am I clear, children? Right. Next I'll go with third criterion, that is angle side angle concurrence criterion. So ASA. So the same way here also I have two triangles, one pink and green. See here I mentioned angle. This one line is there now. This angle and this angle are equal. And double line is are putting now. These two angles are equal, right? Suppose instead of keeping like this, if I kept like this, these two triangles are not getting matched. So I have to keep like this. Then only these two triangles are getting matched. That is based on which criteria? Angle side angle. So these two angles are equal in these both triangles. See, this angle and this angle are equal, and this angle are equal, and this side we can say this or this or this side, any side you can take, so no problem. So any one side is equal. So based on ASA criteria, these two triangles are equal. See, these two triangles are concurrents based on which criteria? Angle, side angle. Got it, children? Right. Next, I'll go with fourth criteria, that is hypotenuse. That is, see, look at these two diagram. These two diagrams are same. That is, see, I'll show you with one example. Listen here. So here I have a triangle. For example, yes. See here, how I am going to match these two triangles now. Right angle triangle. Right angle triangle in the sense like this it should be. That is, this one angle should be equal to 90 degree. So here in this triangle, this is 90 degree. In this pink color, this is 90 degree. So I have to match in this way. Have to take this triangle and keep like this. Now, see here, this is 90 degree. Hypotenuse are equal, so RHS or in the sense right angle, H means hypotenuse, S means side, RHS criterion. So based on this condition, these two triangles are concurrents. Am I clear, children? So now we saw four types, that is SSS, side criterion, and then SAS criterion, that is side angle, side, then ASA criterion, angle, side angle, at last RHS criterion, that is right angle, triangle criterion, that is RHS criterion. Based on these four criterion, here we are going to do sums in this exercise. Listen to me carefully. I'll go with first sum. Exercise 4.2, given that triangle ABC is concurrent to triangle DEF. List all the corresponding concurrent sides. List all the corresponding concurrent angle. This is our first question in exercise 4.2. See here, I'm going to draw the diagrams. Listen, take these two triangles. This is triangle ABC. This is triangle DEF. So given these two triangles are concurrent, that is these two are equal in say and size. We have to list the corresponding concurrent sides and corresponding concurrent angle. How you do it? Sides, take AB. AB equal to ED. ED. Yes, next this BC, BC equal to EF. Yes, next AC is equal to DF. So this is corresponding sides, concurrent sides. This is corresponding concurrent side. How you can say that corresponding angles? See that angles here, I'm going to write it over here, the angles. Angle A is equal to angle D, or else you can mention this angle BAC. Angle BAC is concurrent to angle EDF. EDF. Yes. Next, which angle? This angle. So here I am going to put double line. This is first angle. The one line is mentioned that these two angles are equal, and you have to understand. Two lines are there now. These two angles are equal meaning. Okay, children? Right. This angle I am going to mention it as angle ABC is concurrent to angle DEF. Angle DEF. Yes? Next, third angle is this. For third angle, just here I am going to draw three lines. This I am going to write it as angle BCA is concurrent to angle EFD. EFD. Yes, children? So here I don't have enough space. So what I wrote it here, don't get confusion. These three sides are equal. These three angles are equal. Right? See. Next, I'll go with second sum. See here. Second question. If the given two triangles are concurrent, Then identify all the corresponding sides and also write the corresponding angles. Same like that first sum. There we drawn the triangle and we show it. But here we have diagram. Seeing this diagram, you have to do the sum. See, one line is there in this side means, that means this and this side are equal. That is PQ and LN are equal. That is line PQ is concurrent to LN. Line PQ is concurrent to LN, or else you can put equal, no problem. Next, this line PR, that is PR is equal to double N, where it is here LM, LM. Next side PQ, PQ is equal to LMN, PQ is equal to MN. This is sides, corresponding sides. So corresponding angles, while writing corresponding angles, first one line, here alone you have one line, so angle P. So angle, you can mention this as RPQ, RPQ is equal to NLM, 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 right? Next three angle is this, that is angle PRQ is equal to LMN, angle LMN, right? Third one is this angle PQR, angle PQR is equal to LNM, angle LM, sorry, LNM. That's all. Just look at this diagram and we can write it, okay? So one line means, here also we have one line on this line segment, so these two sides are equal. That means two, these two sides are equal. Double line is there, no? These two lines are equal. Triple line is there, so these third side, this is the, these two sides are equal in the same way, angles also. Right, children? Right. In the same way, second sum, look at this diagram. So this is also very, very easy, children. So this RQ and LM are equal. Or PR and LN are equal, and PQ is equal to NM. Just see the symbols and take and write. Okay, children. Next, corresponding angles. That is this symbol means right angle triangle. Angle P, or PQ is equal to LNM. LNM. Next angle, this one Q. PQR is equal to LMN. Yes? Next angle is, first angle RPQ is equal to LNM. Second angle is PQR is equal to LMN. Yes. Third one is, look at this angle, that is PRQ is equal to NLM. Am I clear? Right. Next, question number 3. This question is, third question. Here we have two triangles. So, in this triangle, we have to say, that is in the given triangle ABC and EFG are concurrent. Determine whether the given pair of sides and angles are corresponding sides or corresponding angles or not, we have to say. So here in the question itself, angle A and G are corresponding side on, they were asking, corresponding angles on, we have to say. Angle A and G, this is angle A, this is angle G. Here we have double leg, here we have single leg. So these two angles are not corresponding angles. So you have to write like that answer, right? Next, second one. Angle B and angle E. This is angle B. This is angle E. So here they didn't give any lines. But here they were given one line. So these two angles are also not corresponding. Yes. Are not corresponding angles. Next. Angle B and angle G. Angle B. This is angle B. This is angle G. Here we have one single line. But here they didn't give any lines. So the angle B and angle G, these two angles are See children, here we have one mistake in this book. That is, here one line should come in the question. Here it won't come, okay? So now angle B and G are corresponding angles, right? Next, sides. Line AC and GF. AC and GF. Here we have two lines, but here we have three lines. So these two lines are not corresponding lines, right? Next, BA and FG. BA and FG. These two lines, three lines. Here also we have three lines. So these two sides are corresponding sides, right? Next, EF. EF and BC. EF and BC. Here we have only one single line, but here we have double line. So these two lines are also not corresponding sides. These two sides also are not corresponding sides. Right. Next, look at this question. State whether the two triangles are concurrent or not. Justify your answer. Here I am going to tell you people orally everything, but in the PDF I will send you full history. Okay, you people, you have to write that conditions also in the classwork. Okay, children. Right. First, look at this diagram. See, here we have two triangles. That is, consider this as ABC. Triangle ABC. See, consider this as triangle ABC. This BC, this line is divided as two part. So, line AD is a midpoint. So, now these two triangles, these two sides are 90 degree. So, this is 90 degree. These two angles are equal. But in the diagram itself, they were given these two angles are equal. And AB equal to AC. AB equal to AC. These two sides also equal. It is given there in the question. This is common side. This side is common for both the triangle, right? So, and angle BAD, BAD and DAB. These two angles are equal. It is given in the question. So, in which criteria we can say these two triangles are equal? Side, angle, side. That is, side, angle, side. Side, angle, side. Using this criteria, we can say these two triangles are equal. See, listen, I will explain to you. See, this is the given triangle. So, here these two angles are equal. It is given there in the book. And these two sides are also equal. Yes? So, this line is divide these two triangles as equal part. This is common for both the triangle. So this side also equal. So side, angle, side criteria. These two triangles are concurrent. We can say these two triangles are concurrent. Yes. Next, look at this diagram. Here we have up and down one triangle. See, I'm going to draw and show to you. See children, we have a diagram like this. Yes, right. Here one line, here and here two lines, and here we have two lines. Right. Look at this diagram. See, this is common. This line is common for both this triangle. Right. This line is common for both this triangle. And they were given. So, this and these lines are equal. And this line are double line. Here we have double line. So, these two sides are equal. So, this is side. This side is common for both the triangle. And this are equal. And this are equal. Here which criteria? Yes. S criterion. Based on this criterion, these given two triangles are equal. Am I clear? Right. Next diagram. See. This is the next diagram. These two angles are equal and these two lines are equal. This is given in the diagram, right? So here, these two, how we can say which criteria it will come over here? See, now let the given triangles ABC, consider if you want, we can give names or you can write it. These two triangles are given over here. AC, that is, this and this are equal. This side and this side are equal. That is given. Next, these two angles are given. Right? So now these two lines are vertically, these two lines are intersecting. So we can say vertically opposite angles are equal. Based on this condition, these two angles are equal, these two angles are equal, and these two sides are equal. That is angle side angle criteria. So angle ASA criterion, these two triangles are equal. Okay, in the PDF fully everything I'll mark it as ABC triangle and DEF triangle. Based on that I will give you the notes. You people, you have to write it in your classwork. Yes, am I clear? Right. Next, fourth diagram. See, look at this fourth diagram. Right. So this is 90 degree symbol. Okay. These two sides are equal. Right. Now this line is common for both this triangle. The center line is common for both this triangle. And these two sides are equal. It is there given in the diagram itself. These two angles are 90 degree. So this is hypotenuse. This is hypotenuse. So our right angle or hypotenuse H side or HS criterion. These two triangles are concurrent. Okay. Puridama? Yes. These two triangles are concurrent. May clear, children? Again, I'll repeat. In these two triangles, this line is common. That is hypotenuse. That is equal for both the triangle. Right? And these two sides are equal. That is given in the question. This is right angle triangle. So, based on RHS criterion, we can say these two triangles are concurrent. Yes. Next. Last one, fifth one. Yes, this is the given diagram. So in this triangle also, this middle line, this is common for both, right? So now we can say this is 90 degree, this is 90 degree. We can, I think no need to go with angle. So we can say with another criterion, that is, this side is equal for both the triangle and these two sides are equal. It is given there in the diagram and these two sides are also equal. So, which criteria we can say here? Yes, yes, yes. Side criterion, we can say these two triangles are equal. That is concurrent. Am I clear, children? Right. Next, I'll go with next sum. So this one, if you have book, you can do this sums in the book itself. Otherwise, you people, you have to do in your classwork. To conclude the concurrency of triangle, mark the required information in the following figure with reference to the given concurrency criterion. So here they were given ASA criterion, angle, side, angle. But here we have only this angle alone equally they were given. So angle side angle, not definitely this angles also should be equal. So you have to put a mark like this in the diagram. That's all the answer. Okay, angle side angle. Yes, children. Right. Next one is side criterion. Okay, already it is given there in the book. These two sides are equal and these two sides are equal. This third side alone missing. So here you have to draw these three lines. Third side mentioned. Okay, so three lines here you draw and three lines you draw in this side. So that's all. Based on SSS criterion, these two triangles are concurrent. Yes. In the next diagram, RHS criterion. RHS na right angle, that is given in the diagram itself. Hypotenuse. Hypotenuse in the sense this. These two sides are equal, right? Next, side. Which side alone? This side is common. So, you just draw a line like this. Yes, children? That's all. Very simple. Next. Next criterion, ASA. ASA, that is these two angles are given in the question itself, they were given and these two angles are equal. So what it will happen, these two angle side angle, so these two sides definitely it will be equal, or you can mark it over here anywhere. Okay, so now this is equal, so you can say this based on this ASA criterion, so these two triangles are concurrent, right? Next, fifth one, SAS, side angle side. So this is vertically opposite angles, right? So side angle side, here they were given two lines. So another side automatically you can mention here or this side, whatever it may be. So put a small line over here. That's all the answer, children. Am I clear? Right. Next one, last sum in this exercise. For each pair of triangles, state the criterion. Here criterion is given, so we've drawn the lines. But here we have to say based on which criteria these two triangles are concurrent. So this is common. Already I told this is common. So these two sides are equal. These two sides are equal. So we can say SSS criterion. Based on SSS criterion, these two triangles are concurrent. Next, here these two angles are equally given. And these two sides are equal. So automatically, definitely, this is vertically opposite angles. These two angles are equal. So here we can say angle side angle criteria. Based on angle side angle criteria, these two triangles are equal. Yes, children? Next, right angle or HS criterion. So see here. Listen. These two triangles, we have to say these two triangles based on which criterion or HS, because here these two lines are given and these two lines are given, they were given lines, two lines are given over here. So these two lines and these two lines are equal, this and this and this and this. So here 90 degree, so we can say this or HS criteria. Based on this criteria, these two triangles are equal. Yes, Kana? Right. Next, here look at these two diagrams. Angle, two angles are equal and these two lines are equal. So definitely while you take adjust to match and see this side, definitely this angle and this side equal, not automatically another angle also will be equal. So based on ASA criteria, these two triangles are concurrent, right? Next, this is the common side. These two angles are equal and these two angles are equal. These two angles and these two angles are equal. This is the common side. So we can say ASK, angle side angle. Angle side angle criteria. Based on this criteria, these two triangles are concurrent. Next, in this diagram, see, these two sides are equal and these two sides are equal. Automatically, these two lines are intersecting. Vertically opposite angles are equal. So side angle side, side angle side criteria, we can use it. So based on side angle side criteria, these two triangles are concurrent. Am I clear, children? Right. Now see, this objective, this one is practical geometry questions. Already we did in that last class. So objective questions: if two plane figures are concurrent, then they are same shape and size. Which of the following methods are used to check the concurrence of plane figure? Now, superposition method. Superposition, now we have to keep an object above that, right? Superposition object. Which of the following rule is not sufficient to verify the concurrency of two triangles? So we learn SSS rule and SAS and ASA. We didn't learn about this. So this is not sufficient, right? Next one is, two students draw a line segment each. What is the condition for them to be concurrent? They should have the same length. If two line segments are concurrent, only one condition is that, that is they should have the same length. In the given figure, AD equal to CD and AD equal to CD and AB equal to CB. AB equal to CB. Identify the other three pair that are equal. See, yeah, the which one will be equal? Angle ADB and equal to angle CDB. These two angles will be equal because these two lines are equal. No? Automatically, we can say these two angles are equal. So next one, ABD. ABD equal to angle CBD. This one. Yes, these two angles are equal. Next, BD equal to BD. That is, this is equal. That this is common for both this triangle. Next, in triangle ABC and triangle PQR, angle A is equal to 50 equal to angle P. That means two angles are equal length, the equal measure, 50 degree. And PQ equal to AB and PR equal to AC. So, by which property we can say that triangle ABC and triangle PQR are concurrent? Definitely we can say side angle side. So, this two sides and one angle is equal. So, SAS property. Am I clear, children? I'll send you this PDF. Please complete it in your classwork. Thank you, children.